Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome once again to Amazed by the Qur'an, a series in which I share with you what I find amazing about the Qur'an. Today, inshallah, I want to share with you something that's, again, somewhat technical, but my job is to try to make it easy to understand. In the Arabic language, there are two ways of saying wasn't. Okay, so you can say lam yakun, wasn't, or ma kana also means wasn't. But the difference is that when you say ma kana, the latter, then it actually means to refute. Like, for example, he wasn't a teacher. If somebody asked, was he a teacher? I could say, lam yakun ustadan. He wasn't a teacher. I'm answering somebody's question. But if somebody makes the false claim, he was a teacher, and I go after them and say, no, you're wrong. He was definitely not a teacher. You are wrong about that, sir. Then I don't say, lam yakun. I say, ma kana ustadan. So the word ma, basically, to make it easy, the word ma is used for refutation purposes. It's there to correct an incorrect assumption. Okay, so there are two ayat, one belonging to the sixth surah, Surah Al-An'am, and the other belonging to Surah Hud, the 11th surah. Very similar ayat. أَلَّمْ يَكُنْ رَبُّكَ ذَلِكَ أَلَّمْ يَكُنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ رَبُّكَ مُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى. And the other, مَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ لِيُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى. Allah was not one to destroy towns. Both in English translation say, your master was not one to destroy towns. Okay, but in one of them he says lam yakun, wasn't. And the other he says ma kana, he wasn't at all one to destroy towns. In other words, in one he's simply making a statement of fact, he wasn't one to destroy towns. And in the other one he's refuting someone and telling them he wasn't one to destroy towns at all. So why refute one in one case? It's the same exact statement. Why make it refutational in one context and make it simply a matter of fact in the other? You'll notice in Surah Al-An'am, he just states it as a matter of fact. It's not even a debate with someone. He's not correcting anyone. It's actually a scene describing Judgment Day. And on Judgment Day, all arguments have come to an end. There's nothing to refute. It's all fact now. Nobody denies anything anymore. So he puts it as a matter of fact. As a matter of fact, your master was never one to just destroy towns, bi dhulmin, wrongfully. He would never do that. On the other hand, if you study Surah Hud, it's actually talking about a debate happening between the believer and the disbeliever in this world, where the disbeliever is making a claim that your God destroys nations wrongfully. And he's being corrected and he's being told, no, he doesn't destroy nations wrongfully at all. Ma kana. So every even phrase that you find in English translation, exactly the same, is actually very different in the Arabic, you know? And then there's the other really beautiful thing here. Destroyer of towns. Destroyer of towns, muhlik al-qura, as opposed to destroys towns. Now think about the English. Destroyer is a noun. Destroyer of towns, therefore, are two nouns, destroyer and towns. But if I say, your master doesn't destroy towns, or he would never destroy towns, when you use the verb, right, it's different. So actually, in the scene that's on about Judgment Day, he used a noun for destroying. He called himself a destroyer of towns, muhlik al-qura. But in the scene that's describing this world, he says he destroys towns. He used a verb. Now what's the difference between a noun and a verb? A noun is permanent, set, unchanged, immobile. And a verb is shifting. Like a verb is an act that's taking place or might take place. But it's not a constant. It's incredible that for Judgment Day he used the noun, because just like a noun is set, immobile, it is the decisions on Judgment Day that are set and immobile. But in this world, there are nations that may rebel against God, but they might find their way back. Allah's decision about them hasn't been set in stone. They still have a chance to earn forgiveness. He didn't condemn anybody and make any nation God-forsaken, as the term is used. Nope. The verb is used to suggest that in this world, people have a chance to change. Entire nations have a chance to change. Allah will never destroy a nation wrongfully. The verb is used, because he hasn't become a destroyer of them. Had he used the word destroyer, their fate would have been sealed. So the people who argue, well, number one, that he did that before, or the number to imply that he'll do it again, both of those are refuted just in the language that is captured inside the ayah, which to me is not only the part of the literary beauty of the Qur'an, but in that literary beauty, what is captured is the loving mercy and justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah once again give us the ability to reflect on the Qur'an as it deserves to be reflected on. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.